in an interview, I think it was recorded at the weekend, that he's been subjected to racial abuse both on and off the pitch in Scotland, but he insisted it wouldn't drive him out. He said he's had things thrown at him, comments made about his mother, etc., etc. And he believes he gets treated differently to other players in similar situations. Why did he say that?
I don't understand the question. Why did he say it?
Yeah.
Well, because he sat down.
Is he making up?
Because he was sat down to do an interview.
Is he making up?
Well, let me just touch on this. It's disappointing to hear these things, but we've also just heard Dennis McInnes talking about Shay Logan.
Yeah, we'll get more of that shot. So
he's not alone, right? He's not alone. But
that doesn't make it right. And
no, exactly.
Make that
as point. I just said that. I said it doesn't. You know, that's exactly what I just said. It doesn't make it right, and it's disappointing to hear those things. But when you're making accusations like that, where's the evidence? Again. Now, the lack of evidence is not evidence in itself of it not happening. But when you're making big statements like that, where is the evidence? Where's the evidence? And I tell you what's more concerning, and this is the point I was going to make earlier when Daryl was touching on it, is why is it today that that story and that interview is being done? Why? Alfredo Morelos has done his first interview today with Sky Sports. It was filmed on Friday. Last week, there was a story in the newspaper about somebody tampering with the brakes of his sports car. Now, who fed that line? Because it certainly wasn't the police. So somebody fed the Daily Record that line about tampering with brakes. Sunday Mail had the story that that wasn't strictly true. That newspaper perhaps leaked that story back to whoever it was that had leaked them the story in the first place. And there was an interview set up and recorded on Friday that's released today that then gets everybody distracted, talking about something else, which is it's a poor story. Racism in Scotland, we don't want it. I think we condemn it. If there's evidence, we condemn it, quite rightly so. But let's go back to the main story here, that last week somebody leaked a story about tampering with brakes, completely unfounded. And what does it do? I get messages saying that I'm, you know, complicit in attempted murder, along with other people. Utter garbage. And that's what I find extremely disappointing, because somebody is stoking fires for their own personal gain. And I tell you, you know, Rangers is a club. They have a guy who's in charge of their media, their PR, Jim Traynor. He's a dangerous character.
He's not here to defend himself. You're right. That's not our view. He will feel he's representing the club.
Uh-huh.
And as Alfredo Morelos has come out and said he feels he's on the receiving end, he's treated differently, he's been abused.
Kenny, I'm talking about separate situations now. I'm talking about Rangers have a guy who's in charge of the PR. I'm not talking about that, I'm talking about this now. Here's a guy who's a bully. He's a bully. He releases
this, Michael, this is a guy who will feel he's standing up for his club, and a lot of Rangers fans will be happy he's doing that.
Kenny, you're fine to put that point forward. He did an interview with Rangers TV in February last year talking about, I'm just looking for balance and accuracy, okay? This is the same guy that sent emails to Craig White to okay articles that he was then going to write about him. Now, how is that balanced and accurate when you're actually wanting the person you're writing something about to give editorial clearance to something you're writing about? That's not balanced and accurate. That's not balanced and accurate, Kenny. This guy is creating division for his own personal gain because he is subcontracted to deal with these things.
That's your personal opinion that he's got too much power at Rangers. A lot of Rangers fans will disagree with that.
Yeah, but you know, they probably will, but again, I think the Rangers support and the club as a whole are being done a disservice here, because the wider picture is reputationally, out in the big world, the reputation is being done damage by the actions of James Traynor. And they need to recognise that, okay, some of the supporters will lap it all up, as they will, but the reputation in the wider world is doing damage. You know, there's another example, the council asset transfer, the community asset transfer of the park opposite Ibrox. You try to work in conjunction with people. Instead, they go to war against others.
That's a political issue, isn't it?
No, Kenny,
that's a political issue which you've probably got a stake in.
But Kenny, How have I got a stake in it?
Well, I mean,
that's also
also without getting carried away, and you've had to go at Michael over the kind of politicising it. That, and I've been in the movie with Hampden Park. Actually, the council got the raw end of the deal there because that's a matter for the community council. So without this becoming a political programme...
My point I'm talking about is you need to come together to try and work these things through. But the problem is that Jim Traynor tries to stoke fires and create division because he's the guy that then has to be hired to put those fires out. And it does the club and the fans a disservice, as far as I'm concerned.
I think that's an overly simplistic view.
Well, how is it?
Do you know for a fact that that was Jim Traynor, as you seem to be alluding to?
That what was Jim Traynor?
The episode in the last week and the placing of the story.
I wasn't talking about that with Jim
Traynor.
No, but
that's how it will be perceived to the outside world.
I wasn't talking about that.
Well, that's fine.
I was quite clear. I said to Kenny that I'm not talking about that. I was talking about something else.
So why mention it then?
About what? Because I'm talking about the bigger picture.
You brought a name in.
Yes,
to
because
a conversation.
Yes, because I'm talking about the bigger picture.
No, but you can't surely
Darryl, sorry, I'm talking about the bigger picture with regards to the PR or the lack of PR that comes out from
let's put a PR hat on. If that was a deliberate PR placement, it's backfired spectacularly, given what is now supposedly the reality of the situation.
We have no evidence that is the case.
What part?
That it was a deliberate placement of a story.
I never said it was.
Just to clarify.
Then it's backfired spectacularly. Michael also made the point that it wouldn't have come.
Well, who's talking about it, apart from us, that we brought this story up? Who's talking about that today?
What do you mean?
The backfiring.
I think if you go on social media, depending on... Again, I go back to this polarised narrative.
What's in the headlines? What's in all the headlines today?
But you're talking about traditional media.
What's in the headlines today?
Alfredo Morelos talking about how he feels he's treated differently and victimised in Scottish football.
Not about the fact that there was a story leaked to the press about his car being tampered with that turned out to be completely unfounded. Now, this was a police matter.
Well,
and now it's been completely contradicted.
Listen, I go back to Mike and I...
And that's not been spoken about today, Kenny, other than here right now. And I think because we've got a platform, that's why I'm trying to put it forward, because in the bigger picture here, you've got a society that's being divided by people like that. And it's not good. Power with as little accountability as possible.
Yeah, and I've made the point, I'll go back to it, the nuclear arms race of whataboutery. There has long been the view that it has to be balanced out and Morelos is treated differently to anybody else. This weekend, it's Lee Griffiths being treated differently. It's nonsense. It's pathetic. And on the specific case of Morelos and the car, it's like a Scooby-Doo episode when initially, to take Michael's point, and Michael's clearly been given some grief on social media, so I understand that it's upsetting to him, but the article, having read it again today for context, was about, you know, alleged tampering. Turns out that by all accounts, it was a private investigator, and I go back to my Truman Show analogy, it's yet another headline that has Alfredo Morelos in the media that Alfredo Morelos can do without. And why is it there? It's there because, unfortunately, he's become a bit of a pantomime figure who's revered as much for his off-field antics and disciplinary issues as he is as being one of the best goal scorers in Scottish football.
What about his comments today, then, about who-